Can your motherboard do this? Hey guys, welcome and welcome back to my channel, Real Metal Tan. First things first, thank you ASUS Singapore for lending me this ASUS Strix Z690E Gaming Wi-Fi to review. Yes, everyone's raving about the awesome Q release on this motherboard, but there are actually more noteworthy features on this motherboard. But before we get to the board, let's do a very simple unboxing. Alright, let's open the box. Okay, so first thing, we have the motherboard. Let's set it aside first. I have removed the manual. This is the manual. Okay, there's another box inside the box. This is where all of the accessories are. Okay, so this is the HyperM M.2 card. The DVD for chipset drivers. This guy saved me the first time when I got this motherboard, but right now the board is launched, so just download the latest drivers from the ASUS website. The ROG keychain. Thank you card from ASUS for buying this motherboard. You definitely have to jazz up your motherboard with stickers. This is your Wi-Fi 6E antenna. This is pretty awesome. The ASUS ROG graphics card holder. More on this later. Yep, these are the M.2 rubber packages. A whole package of cable ties. 4 SATA cables. This guy on the left, I believe, is an additional Q-latch. And this is the back plate for a Q-latch. Kind of confusing, but I guess this is what they are. And lastly, these are a pair of screws for you to install SSDs on the HyperM M.2 card. Because the HyperM M.2 has 2 SSD slots, that's why you have a pair of them. And back to this motherboard. Are you ready? Let's go! The centerpiece of this motherboard, of course, is a new LGA 1700 socket supporting your new 12th gen CPUs. The first noteworthy thing here, unlike the other Z690 motherboards that I've shown you, you can see there's 2 pairs of drill holes. This means this motherboard supports both LGA 1700 as well as 1200 coolers. However, ASUS recommends that you use the LGA 1700 cooler for this motherboard. It is not to say that you can't use LGA 1200, but make sure that you check your cooler before installing on this motherboard. Talking about Intel 12th Gen, this motherboard comes with 2 8-pin CPU power in. But question is, do you really need to use both 8 pins? Well, one pin is rated for 260 to 280 watts, and Intel's 12900K at its PL2 state consumes about 240 watts of power. So technically, you can survive with just one 8-pin if you plan to use a 12900K on this motherboard. But anyway, since there's an additional 8-pin here, just plug it in. More power does not hurt for your CPU. A small noteworthy thing here, if you do not plug in the 8-pin, there's an LED here that will light up to remind you to do so. Okay, before we get on to the main awesome part of this Z690E, let's take a look at some headers and ports that you may want to know. First, going on with the new ASUS motherboard fashion, the AIO pump header is next to the CPU socket, making it very convenient to plug in and route your AIO pump wire. There are no shortage of fan headers, up to 5 of them on this new motherboard. One at the top, next to the CPU power, one next to the pump header, 2 on the right, next to the SATA ports, and 1 more at the bottom right, before the front panel headers. Next, similar to the top Z690, if you need to jazz up your PC, there are 3 ARGB headers on this motherboard, one on the top and 2 on the bottom left, and 1 12V RGB header next to the top ARGB header. Next, as this is a Strix motherboard, you get both the QLED as well as the Q-code LEDs for diagnostics. I like how ASUS gives a different color to each of the 4 diagnostics, so you can easily tell what's wrong with your PC during boot. On the other hand, the Q-code LED is very useful at any time. If there's an issue which you can't figure out, just see the code and refer to the manual. You will be able to resolve the issue which you are facing. Next up, if you need to clear your CMOS and are wondering, where's the clear CMOS jumper? Okay, there's none, but don't fret. At this price range, you have a clear CMOS button at the back I/O. And yes, more on the back I/O at a later part of the video, so make sure to stay tuned for that. Alright, let's go on to the main meat of this Z690E. Coming from the Z590E, which has 4 M.2 slots and 6 SATA ports, this Z690E has 1 more M.2 slot, giving it 5 M.2 slots and 6 SATA ports. You are lying! There's only 3 M.2 slots! Wait, hold your horses. There are 5 M.2 slots, of which Two of them are found on the Hyper M.2 card. I am not going to go through all of the slot configs for the Hyper M.2 card, which can be a topic for another video, but the main M.2 slots are as follows. The first M.2 slot operates at PCIe 5.0x4, while the second and third slot operates at PCIe 4.0x4. If you have a SATA M.2 SSD, install it in the third M.2 slot. If you manage to fit in all 5 M.2 slots, think about it. RAID 5 file server? Oh my goodness! Ah, sorry, can't get enough of this awesome Q release. This first slot is PCIe 5.0x16. Important note here, if you are a plug-in SSD in the first M.2 slot, this PCIe 5.0 slot only operates at half its speed at x8 instead of the full x16 speed. A bit of a bummer here, but I guess there's probably not enough lanes to serve two full-length PCIe 5.0 as well as M.2 5.0 slots. This means if you want to have your full-length 5.0 x16 speed, you will need to install SSD in the other M.2 slots. I am sure ASUS will have a better solution for this, for let's say the Z890E or even a Z990E if and when PCIe 5.0 devices do appear. Actually, what's the difference between a PCIe 4.0 x16 and a 5.0 x8? Anyone knows? You also can write down in the comments below. Apologies, back to topic. The second PCIe slot is PCIe 3.0 x1, great for your sound cards or your Full HD capture cards. I like that there's ample space between the first slot, which is reserved for your beefy GPU, and the second slot. So you can use this second slot if you need to. The third and fourth slots may look like full-length x16 slots, but they operate at x4 speeds for regular PCIe devices. You can use a 4K capture card like Elgato's 4K60 on the third or fourth slots. Or if you want to have a Thunderbolt interface in your PC, you can install a Thunderbolt card on the fourth slot because it's closest to the Thunderbolt header as well as the USB 2.0 headers. Also, another thing to point out, do you remember this guy? The GPU support bracket? It is more than a GPU support bracket. You have a nice MATX build, you have a nice reservoir in the corner, and you want to get GPU out, but somehow you can't reach the Q release button. What do you do? Do this! This is ASUS Magic GPU 1! So cool! Alright, let's now go on to the back of the board. Okay, going from left to right, you have your usual 1DP, 1HDMI. Next to it, at the top, 2 USB 2.0 ports, and any price range, of course, you must have a clear CMOS button mentioned earlier, as well as a BIOS flashback button. Next to it, 4 Type-A ports, these are Gen 1, 2 more USB 2.0 ports, at the bottom, a Gen 2 Type-A and a Gen 2 Type-C. Next to it, a 2.5G LAN port, and at its bottom, another USB Gen 2 Type-A and a Gen 2 x2 Type-C port. You also have your usual gold connectors for your Wi-Fi 6E antenna giving you Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth 5.2, as well as audio jacks and optical SPD out port. Okay, so what do I think about this new Z690E? Of course, coming from ASUS as a Strix motherboard, it's really awesome, a lot of features, a lot of M.2 slots, PCIe slots, and of course the very magic Q release. But, this is to you. I'm not an ASUS mouthpiece. There are some things which we will prefer to have on this motherboard. Number one, we get that it's pretty awesome to have 5 M.2 slots on this motherboard. Yes, it's pretty cool to have the Hyper M.2 card included in the box, but we don't see anyone using that Hyper M.2 card for 2 more SSDs or even 4 more SSDs. Perhaps removing the Hyper M.2 card will make the motherboard $200 cheaper? Number two, yes, you have 4 PCIe slots on this motherboard, but Gordon and I prefer to have 2 slots capable of running PCIe x8 x8 speed each. But this config's only found on the higher-end ASUS ROG motherboards, which cost so much money. Yeah, if you're an ASUS fanboy, go for it. And number 3, the DDR5 issue. This is not an issue that's only on this motherboard. We also see the same issue with the other brand's motherboard, being that DDR5 RAM is either 1, too expensive, or 2, kind of non-existent. But yeah, don't worry, the other option is to buy a DDR4 motherboard, such as the ASUS TUF Z690D4 motherboard they reviewed the last time. Alright, if you like my overview of this motherboard, make sure to smash the thumbs up button. And yes, in the meantime, you can also catch my review of the ASUS TUF Z690D4 below. And make sure to smash the subscribe button to not miss out on more awesome tech content. See you next episode.